Welcome back to the Mindcrack. This is episode number 13 on the Mindcrack Minecraft multiplayer server. Season 6. Did I say season 6 more than once? I'm not sure. Try to say everything at least once, more than once, and that's just a free bonus. So we have dropped a lot of sand. We have removed all the exterior water. Today we're going to basically just bulldoze all of this. It's gotta go. It doesn't technically have to go. In fact, we could have made a very functional, very quick guardian farm and left all of it intact and just built around it. I did see that a friend of mine, a YouTube buddy, Zizuma, sent me a video, and I say, no, we will not do the functional, the practical build. We are going to burn it to the ground. Actually, I'm going to pick up all the blocks with my pickaxe because I want to use these blocks, but we're probably not going to get to the actual farm today. What we're going to start with is we are going to remove everything from here. We also need to, in addition to removing the guardian farm, we need to light up the caves under the ocean in the area to prevent any extra spawns. As far as I know, there's not a practical way to keep squids from spawning outside of our boundary here. Short of draining even more of the ocean, and I think I've done enough of that. But just lighting up the caves and building the farm, we should have a ridiculous number of guardians dropping, so we'll have an infinite number of these blocks to sell and to make tons of diamonds. I know Vintage Beef is waiting to spend all of his diamonds. He's waiting to give us all his diamonds, and we are ready to take all of his diamonds. Okay, that sand can stay. I've got my Aqua Affinity Respiration Helmet and my Depth Strider 3 Flippers. This should be fairly smooth, and a nice thing about digging down into this monument is that there's all these nice little convenient pillars to break up the water spread. So hopefully I won't need to drop all that much sand. Hopefully we can just make straight with the sponges. Clean out these areas. Let's just take the top off. Pick up all the blocks. Oh, some of it dropped all the way down there. I guess I don't really need to be that careful about it. No guardians. There's still plenty of space for them to spawn. And I suppose I could pick this up after I do the spongy doos. Maybe that's even a faster idea. But just for the first little part, we'll do that because we've got to kind of get a feel for what we're doing again. Been a while since I've dried up some ocean monument stuff. Yes. Oh, very practical. This is what sponges were made for. I've heard a number of people say after they've finished emptying out a ocean monument, they no longer have anything useful to do with sponges. Maybe we'll try to think of something. But there, just like that, we have drained this initial layer. So that's what we're going to do. I don't know if we're going to do anything else today. I will try not to make it all about just the one thing. And since it's going to take so long, of course, we're going to do most of it off camera. But since there's so much to do, we may as well make... Oh! Okay, I'll go get that in a second. Got to make sure I keep all 34. I had 34 to begin with, and I haven't lost any yet. I don't know that there's another... I don't think the guardians actually dropped the sponges. So this may be all we get. I might even... Maybe we could even raid some other monuments just to snag more sponges and sell those at one of our shops. I bet we could sell those for a lot. I don't know what people want them for or to use them for. Anyway, okay, yeah. All that to say, 2330. Yeah, let's get that before I forget and this despawns. Let's grab this. I've got a lot of work to do, and so we're going to make a montage. Thank you. And we're done. Almost there. So the temple is totally gone except for the very bottom layer. But underneath it, what we have is a little bit more ocean. I guess I didn't look this up or anything, but my hunch is that the ocean monument always spawns at a certain height underneath the surface of the ocean. Maybe something like that. And the ocean here was just fairly deep. So it built, I guess it made, put some stilts on the thing. So there is water under here. And almost every time I've swam under here, I've noticed a whole bunch of guardians under here. So we're definitely going to clear it out. I want to clear it out anyway for my kind of visual idea for the farm. Now, I don't see any guardians in here now, which is odd. Oh, you know what? I bet maybe it's not possible for them to spawn here individually, but mobs do spawn in groups. And what that means is that they'll pick a certain spot. So if there was water inside the monument, it will spawn one there. And then I think it just picks random locations nearby that creature. And it just has to have a certain amount of water. So all the ones I saw underneath were probably packs of the guardians spawning underneath. And then the one was spawning here. Aha! Okay, that's a hunch. That's not science, but it's a guess. So I'm still going to drain this amount of water. So I think that's going to mean we're going to have to do some more sand, but this shouldn't take that long. I mean, it's going to take a little while. Don't get me wrong. It's going to take a little while. This is water. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if there are no guardians, it's going to make it so much nicer. So we're going to do it in strips of 5. And I'm going to do something slightly different in the way I do the sponges this time. Because the water's not going to be nearly as deep. I'm not going to divide it into little vertical squares. I'm going to just do big long strips. Separate them with sand. And then each one I'm just going to basically go down the line with whatever spacing is best. I guess we'll figure it out. And try to do it without subdividing it more. See if we can get this finished. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, that's a little footy. Little footing. Little pedestal. Little stilt. And then there's a little gap there in the middle. But I want to get this done today so that I can stop thinking about it. We still need to light up some caves. I did find some caves down below. And I guess a little bit, as soon as I finish this, we will go take a look at those. There's a mine shaft there. Maybe we'll find some loot or something. So all the trenches have been dug. All of the sand has been filled. I'm going to try just placing the, what's it called? The sponges? Every third block underwater. So I left these guys here. Give me room to place. And I'm kind of curious to see how far this will drop the water. If I will be able to just do the rest from the bottom up, so to speak. I keep hearing that stupid spider. I don't know where he is. I can't find him. There must be a cave very close under the sand here. Boom. Okay, yeah, lovely. We are very close. Let's see if I just do this. Oh, yeah. Yes. Maybe this isn't quite as efficient as what I was doing above. Oh, it got deeper. Dang. I think I can still do it, though. Skipped a bit here. This is a little bit sloppier, but I don't have to place any blocks because I've already got sand on the walls here. And maybe I should probably, it's probably about that time since I already used all of them. I should probably move the furnaces down a little bit closer instead of having to go all the way up that ladder every single time I want to use them. That was pretty quick. Not too bad. So 34 of those almost did the whole thing. And that is way better. Placing that sand was real quick. I'm going to do this real quick, and then I guess we'll go explore them caves. Well, it's all gone. All dug out. All of the water gone. All of the blocks broken with a pick and collected over there in chests. I've expanded my chest supply just a little bit as we've dug up more stuff. There's an Enderman down there, and as you can see, there is at least one slime chunk down here. So I think a good idea, because We will be spending some time here. I'm going to make an automated farm that is also an experience grinder. I got to make sure that guy's not coming for me. I guess I can just dive in the water if he hits me. They do hit hard. I'd have some decent armor. But he could kill me in like 3 shots still. There's a slime chunks here, at least one. So we might make a like a passive slime farm while we're at it. That's fairly minimal, just so we can make some sticky pistons and some slime blocks, that kind of thing. Nothing to overkill. The guardian farm is going to be overkill. We're going to make a gigantic experience grinder, and we're also going to get all of the blocks. And now that I think about it, we also need to kill some squids, because I'm pretty sure last time I looked up the recipes that one of the block types requires squid ink to craft. I think the dark prismarine takes squid ink in addition to the shards and the crystals. The other ones, this takes shard and crystal. I don't remember the exact recipe, but it's something like that. And we can make these and these with just the shards and the crystals. I will have to look up the recipe, but they're all fairly simple. So maybe we'll add like a little squid farm on the side and a slime farm on the side. So those can both operate just passively while we're in the area. And then we'll have an active experience grinder guardian farm that we'll use potions of harming, splash harming on. Got a lot of blocks to go with. And I think what we're going to do, we're going to have a block exchange program with our other developing farm, the Enderman, or not Enderman, the Wither Skeleton farm. Got a lot of leftover sand as well. So I started working a little bit on a Wither Skeleton area last episode. And we need blocks for that. And I started using prismarine because I had it. And now I'm going to need a ton of blocks for that farm. I'm going to make a lot of slabs. And guess what? I'm going to have a lot of... skeleton. I'm going to have a lot of nether bricks. And those can be made into slabs and stairs, which monsters can't spawn on. So that's fantastic for making a gigantic slabbed out area for the guardian farm. There he is. Another thing I need to do, which is what... Is this a dungeon? It is! We need to light up the caves. Oh, I should be wearing my shield. Please die. We need to light up these caves to reduce the number of mobs spawning in the area around our guardian farm. Anything that's not a guardian, a slime, or a squid, I don't want spawning if we can handle it. And actually, let's turn around. I'm going to mine all this stuff later off camera. I just want to do a little bit of exploration on camera. So that's basically... Come on, guy. That's basically the idea. We will cart our prismarine over, at least some of it, to be used in our Wither Skeleton Farm. I had to stop and think of what the name of the things are again. Use it in our Wither Skeleton Farm, which I think is a good look. And I could just use, like, the prismarine blocks here, even though they're spawnable blocks, which is no good. But I could use the nether bricks in the nether, but the whole place is dark and red, so it's kind of boring to use the dark red blocks there. I think the light green blocks there and the dark red blocks here is a cool idea. That's what we're gonna do. Look in the chest, what do we got? Some armor. Okay. More armor, not as good. Okay, we'll be coming back here later. I just wanted to poke my nose around. Since I've been doing so much, just kind of like, not standing exactly one spot, but not moving very much, digging out stuff ad nauseum for so long, I've reached a huge milestone. I want to do just a little bit of exploration, adventuring, monster killing, that kind of thing. Heard a baby skeleton. Okay, you're dead. I think what I'll do, I'm gonna bounce around here because I hear so many enemies all around. I don't want to get surrounded. It's still very possible to die caving in this patch. If you get surrounded and you start getting shot by skeletons from two different directions. Look, we'll just leave random prismarine here and there, I guess. Close that off. Come on, guy. Go. All right, what you got, guy? What you got? And, of course, we will be continuing to work on the other stuff I don't want to start any new projects now that I have so many going. We've got the village on top of the mountain. The village square is almost done, and we can move our base up there and then start expanding to other buildings, hopefully faster. I have to do a lot of block breaking to get more clay to make all those, and for that, I would like to have a beacon with haste 5, or haste 2, or whatever, and an efficiency 5 pickaxe so that we can dig stuff super fast. That should help make things go a little bit smoother, so that's why I started on the wither skeleton area. So we got the mountaintop. Is there gonna be a spoiler here? Dead. There's a skeleton. There's a chest. So the mountaintop. I guess that counts as the base for now. The base build. Don't really have a base build besides that just yet. The mountaintop, the wither skeleton farm, the ocean monument farm, which is also going to include a tiny little slime and squid thing, and then also the two shops at Chunk City. I'm having a hard time like speaking in coherent sentences because I'm trying to focus on the monsters. What do we got? We've got random stuff. Beetroot seeds. I'm pretty sure I already have beetroot seeds, but let's pick it up anyway. And I don't think I'm going to start anything else, unless it's like a one-off, just like a one-day build kind of thing. Until we finish up one of those, which probably, judging by the size of the project, probably going to be the wither skeleton one. I'll have it functional, but I won't have all of the area there's another chest. I won't have the area totally conditioned for a while, and by that I mean I won't have all the spawnable areas around it lit up or removed or slabbed or any of that. The two Endermen. Okay, great. Pushing that minecart around. You were trying to steal the minecart. There's nowhere for you to go, though, buddy. Another golden apple. Can I take all that? Chip, chop, chip, chop. The minecart is not really. Well, it's more valuable than pumpkin seeds. There we go. Oh, and I think there's a new change in 1.11.2. I just heard about this. I haven't actually confirmed it. Maybe they were lying out of their teeth. I think iron ingots were added to the game, and you can now smelt. You can smelt leftover iron and gold armor into iron and gold ingots, which is super cool. Which means all that random armor you get from mob grinders, you can now smelt down and get a little bit of iron out of it, and gold as well, which is really cool. Eventually, I will need a passive mob farm at the mountain for the use of, mostly for gunpowder, I guess, to make TNT, to excavate areas faster. But one thing at a time, another chest. Clunk. Oh, okay, missed. Oh, okay, this is what I'm talking about. Three guys, and on different sizes, you can't really block them like that. Yeah, shoot each other. Infighting. Ascension in the ranks. That's the kind of thing that will get you killed once they start ping-ponging you around and your armor starts to, or your health starts to wither away. That can be trouble. And another card there. Okay, let's take a look at these two cards. Then we'll head back up. Lapis lazuli. Okay, let's just do this. I don't need all of this stuff in my inventory, so we will selectively get rid of it. String, I don't need. We can consolidate this. Bread, I don't need. Two pieces of granite, I don't need. Okay, lovely. And then there was another one right through the wall here. So let's go around the... Oh, okay. Let's go a little bit farther around. Okay, that'll fall down a little bit. Eventually, I will cut that off at the source. Do that. Not so bad. There's also a lot of resources here to be acquired, which is cool. Haven't gone caving in a while. Iron pickaxe. Not really worthwhile or useful at this point. Let's see, what should we get rid of? The crappy bow. Activator rail, I will keep. One piece of moss stone. Three pieces of cobble. I don't need that. One piece of gunpowder. I don't need that. Okay, and I think my inventory is basically full. I haven't even really mined up much stuff or explored that much, but we poked our nose in here. That was really all I wanted to do for the video. Now, how do we find our way out, you ask? Well, I'll tell you, it's not that way. You find your way out by putting the torches on your left and just running till you find your way out. Although it's a little bit harder in mine shafts because of how all of the little tunnels will often double back upon themselves. More little area over there. Plop. Okay, dark area. I don't see a lot of animals or monsters. Here's another chest. Let's just peek. Lapis, what do we got? That's pretty good. Infinity. You know, I'm just going to grab the stuff that already fits in my inventory, and I'll just come back for the actual thing left. Don't have any powered rails, huh? Well, I'll just come back for that. Pretty nice. Oh, what's here? Is this a ravine? No, it's just one of these weird open blocks. I wonder if these things, if the map tried to spawn a spawner, like a dungeon here, and then it failed or some, for some reason and left the whole thing blank. I see those every once in a while and have no idea what they're from. Okay, torches on the left. Torch on the right. Maybe I did come up here. Okay, torch on the left. There's a ladder. Okay, it worked. Hooray. So I guess that is about the end of this video. Gonna wrap it up and try to get it out tonight. It's a bit of darkness. I want to do more exploring, but I'll do that later. I think I'll have some fun caving, get some resources here. And then next episode, we will probably try to finish up our first shop at spawn. I ran out of resources for it, and now I definitely have more. And we need to start selling stuff to get some diamonds. And this thing will continue work on as well. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you liked the montage I made this time. And we will see you next episode. See you. Oh, God. Careful. See you later. Take it easy. Have a good day. Bye-bye.